Today we're going to visit the part of Medellin that everyone tells me to avoid. We're going to El Centro, the center of Medellin. Let's see if it's really as shady as they say. To make it a little bit safer, we're going with a guided tour with Carolina. Let's go.
Hi guys, and welcome to Medellin, Colombia. Today we are joining a free tour and I'm going to take you guys with me. We're going to explore El Centro, the center of Medellin.
And here in front of me, you can see the group of people we're following and our guide Carolina, which is explaining this huge statue here, which is right in front of the government building of the region of Antioquia, which is the region in which Medellin is situated. And here on the other side, we can see este es el muro verde más grande de Colombia. So this is the biggest green wall in Colombia. We can even see a guy up there. Wow, that wouldn't be for me because I am really afraid of heights. And this is actually the Alcaldía de Medellín, which means this is the city hall. Now let's join the tour again. Up here we can see three different flags. The middle one, of course, the Colombian flag. And I guess that one is Medellín. And this one, Antioquia, could be the opposite. We can see the colors green and white, which are also the colors of Atlético Nacional, one of the two football teams here in Medellin. We're making our way through the center now, and you can see we have quite a big group here.
There's some more people here behind me.
Just follow our guide, Carolina. This is the Parque de las Luces, the Park of the Lights. So at night this lights up. Now it's a bit empty.
It's been raining all day, that's why it's quite empty here in the center of Medellin.
So we're gonna go in the busy shopping street here. This is our group. And it's probably gonna be much more busy.
And here behind me is the City Service of Education. I was here 3 years ago and there were a lot of protests going on. Now it's pretty quiet.
As you see, we're in the shopping street now. I've been here before, so I'm at ease, but when you come here the first time, it can be quite overwhelming. Voila. This is the real center of Medellin, guys. Super busy, shops everywhere. All the way under the metro here, which is right above us. Carolina. They sell all kind of stuff here. We have socks, phone cases. Children's clothes for when it gets colder. You have all these typical unbranded shops, local shops, as we know them in many cities all around the world.
Hey bro, busca ropa.
Hola. No, gracias, amigo. Estoy con el grupo. It's okay, I've been okay. You guys are drinking guayrapo. I see. Amigo, ¿cuánto es?
Cuatro.
Cuatro, uno, por favor. The guayrapo. That's what it's made of. Sí, sí, muy bien. Gracias. Gracias, amigo. All right, guys, we have the guayrapo. Now we gotta hurry to join the group again.
That's right. Wow, so good and so fresh. That's one of my favorite drinks here in Colombia. If you need some refreshment, a fresh guayrapo.
Gente,
No, de acá de Guinness, Seni.
Gracias, gracias.
De acá de los jeans.
No entiendo.
Jean.
Ah, no, gracias. No, gracias. Estoy con
el...
Con el grupo de turistas.
Ah, pero perdámonos.
Sí. Otro día, ok. Gracias.
Hoy, jean.
Hoy no. Más tarde.
Dale.
Chao. Oh God, it's so busy here, we can barely move. Look at this guy. Hola. Those are usually Venezuelans selling some candies in exchange for a little money. It's nice, they're not just begging, they're really offering something. Even if it's symbolical, a little candy. Both of my hands are busy now, so I gotta be careful not to get pickpocketed. I don't have a lot in my pockets, just some money, but still. Gracias. We're gonna enter in this shopping center here. I've been here before and it looks really nice from the inside. Look at these decorations, guys. It's like we're entering a palace. Look at this, guys. Absolutely stunning. And you would expect some fancy shops in here, but no, it's all like the same cheap shops as outside. Look at this, guys. So beautiful.
Because things are cheaper than in a regular store or a shopping mall.
So around this area, it's called El Dueco. That's where you can find all the cheap stuff in all of these shops, in here and also outside. Let's go up the escalator here. This place is called El Palacio, and I think you can understand why. Look at this. Look at this, guys, with the Christmas decorations. We have a little food court down here where you can get a coffee. We have a Christmas tree here. We're here on the fourth floor, I think. But you can see it's an art gallery. No more shops here, totally different vibe, very quiet, and it's full of art. Like, we can have a look in here. That's pretty nice, actually. If you come to this shopping center, El Palacio, don't forget to go up to the third and fourth floor, or fourth and fifth, I'm not sure. Anyway, all the way up to see all the art. If we look through the window here, we can see the mountains surrounding Medellin, and I think, oh, that building there, that's the highest building in Medellin. It's called the Needle. That's where we were before, where the tourist guide was giving us some explanation. So beautiful. What do we have in here? Kama Sutra. Wow.
In all the different positions.
I don't know if this can go on YouTube, guys. So many.
Arbol prohibido, forbidden tree.
All right. I don't know which one is your favorite. Damn, that's an interesting one. I have no idea what's on the top floor. Maybe more art. Oh wow, it looks like a panoramic view. And there's a little cafe here. Oh guys, we have a kind of shopping center called Miami here. Look at this, guys. It's very nice. Hola. It's a little bit hidden, so you have to know. I wish you had more time, but we only have 20 minutes. So I almost have to go down again. No time to get a drink here. But it's super nice. What a beautiful lady. Let's take the elevator down here. All right. Let's go down again.
first floor, I guess. Very nice. This guy is Centro Comercial Palacio Nacional. So that's the official name if you guys want to come here. And so definitely come up to the fifth floor to grab a drink. It's super nice.
All right, we got like 5 more minutes before we have to move again with the group. We're back down in the busy street here. Let's see if we can find a snack. We have some watermelon here. That's not what I want. They're selling a lot of stuff here, but not so much food. Have a look here. Nothing to eat here, guys. Just clothes. Wait, let's see what they have here. What's that? Oh, I thought I had food, but they're just selling the they're selling the whole thing. All right. Nothing to see, to eat here. Just clothes, jewelry, more clothes. Yeah, some kind of sweet stuff. It's not what I want right now. And a lot of drinks. Watch this. Everything you need. Hola. I guess we'll just continue the tour and we'll find something to eat later on. So guys, this is how they make their quiet up. Oh. We have some arepas with cheese.
Hello.
It's muy good. Muy bien, sí.
A la orden, la queso a la orden.
¿Qué es el precio?
6,000.
6,000? Okay, más tarde, gracias.
I gotta hurry with the group here.
Pero mi corazón.
We have some street artists here. Not the best singer, to be honest.
Alright guys, if you go into this street, that's where all the street workers are.
So I guess we're not going there.
We're gonna enter this. And like 3 years ago, this wasn't here. But it seems like they secure the area more. So you have to enter through this gate where the police is.
In case someone is robbing here, they cannot just run away. They have to pass one of these gates where the police can catch them.
Right next to the famous street where the street workers are is one of the oldest churches here in Medellin. And it is said that people first go to the street to do the bad stuff and then they go into the church
to confess for their sins.
Even here you can see a lot of working girls hanging around. And we're walking through the Botero Square now and we can already see the first statues here of the typical
like fat statues.
We're now on the Botero Square with the typical statues. People are taking pictures everywhere here with the statues.
And the sun came out, it's really nice. It's been raining a lot today. Finally, the weather is better.
Look, we have all the tourists here. It's much safer than before because
when I came here 3 years ago, it wasn't closed off. So I think it's much better for the tourists. It's a bit sad, it's needed though.
Up there we have the metro running right through the center. And this is a pretty interesting building. It was actually built by a Flemish architect, Govaerts. But apparently, the Colombians didn't like his style. And this building was actually built as the governor's house when they wanted to separate church and state. So people didn't like that it looked like a church. That's why they got into a fight. The Belgian architect left Colombia, and the locals, they just finished it by building a wall. So that's why it looks pretty ugly on this side, actually. We gotta be honest. It's just a plain wall.
So Well, the architect of these statues is Fernando Botero, world famous sculptor and painter. And he actually died in September this year, probably when you watched this video last year, in 2023. So now these statues are even worth more, and even more people are coming here because now he died. You know, an artist gets more famous and more important.
Literally everyone is taking pictures here, local families, tourists. And they're selling all kind of touristy stuff here, like sculptures of the sculptures. Look at this dude. It's like a robot. This is Botero Square, full of people now in the sun. Here we have the statues, and we can see the whole square is fenced off. It's so different from before. Like, this side is totally empty, and then on the other side we have all the shops, all the local sellers.
What a difference from before. I don't know if it's good. It's a bit weird.
Out of the fence area now, so we're in the kind of mess, the market here. So we're gonna follow Carolina, our guide here.
See, everyone is following us. I'm still looking for some food, but it's only closed all around here.
So we're right under the metro, and this is the stop, Parque Berrio. I like these guys. So as soon as you come down from the metro, they're just showing you the pants, trying to convince you to buy
some kind of jeans. Who is buying jeans like that? How many people are saying, oh yes, I would love to buy that jeans? That's a bit strange.
And this is showing I remember it from last time, this is showing the whole history of Colombia. And this here is Parque Berrio,
which is one of the most famous parks here in the center of Medellin. Behind me, you can see it? It's at the metro stop Parque Berrio.
Like, plenty of people hanging out here, selling coffee, all kind of, here, cleaning the shoes. All kind of people who just want to make a buck. Nothing expensive here, everything is probably super cheap. Selling coffee, tea, kind of snacks, lottery. And people just sitting and chilling as well. Kind of sausages. That's really nice because the sun is going down. I think this is probably the last we're gonna see. We can see between the trees here. Oh yeah. So these are lottery tickets. Yeah. Oh wow, they're all selling lottery tickets here. We're walking through some kind of shopping street here now. Quite busy. I think we're going up to Parque San Antonio up there. And the train station is right there. That's where the tram leaves. That's where the metro stop is. You can say it's quite of a mess here, because it's full of buses, full of people, full of shops.
Full of everything, basically. So you gotta be careful with your belongings here as well.
So I like here everywhere, all these high palm trees right in the center of the city. It's really cool.
We want to know what you think about the tour that I just delivered.
Gracias, Carolina.
Guys, the tour is finished. I will put the link where you can find these tour guides in the description. It's a really good tour, I really enjoy it. It's a free tour, but you know, usually they expect to give a tip. And here it's expected to give around $8 to $10 per person.
You just explained us the story here in the end. So this statue was here while there was a festival going on this square here, which is Parque San Antonio. And you can see a bomb exploded, which makes the whole statue looks like this now.
But instead of removing the statue, they just built the same one right next to it.
So here we have the symbol of the new Medellin, the resurrection, and the old with the bomb. We can even see some flowers up there. And we have like a printout of the newspaper behind it.
Hola.
Guys, let's get some buñuelos here. The guide said these are pretty good. And we can see the man making them. Hola. Apparently these ones are without cheese.
Let's see if we can get one with cheese. I want with cheese.
Solo quiero un buñuelo con queso, por favor.
Trust me. Gracias.
All right, guys, we got the buñuelo ready to eat here. Let's take a seat.
I think there's a bench there.
It's getting dark here.
Wow. We got the best bench, but
it's okay. It's all right. We don't have the seat, but it's good. Let's try the buñuelo con queso. Probably very hot. Look at the tea, guys. That's so much better than the regular buñuelo, because the regular one is like donut without sugar. It's pretty plain taste. And this one with cheese, it's a lot better. I like it more.
All right, guys, I'm going to eat the last part of the buñuelo.
Really good.
We're gonna come here, more discos.
That's only 2,000 for a buñuelo with cheese. Without cheese, it's 1,000. So 2,000, that's less than 50 euro cent.
You can just buy them here from the woman straight out of the fat, out of the grease.
It's getting darker. The cyclist just went next to me. I'm still hungry. Like, one buñuelo didn't stop me from being hungry. So let's look if we can find some other food here.
We're still around the San Antonio metro station. Hola.
Hola.
¿Tienes empanadas vegetariano?
No, sí. No.
¿Con papas? No.
Tengo de carne molida o pizza, pero la pizza trae jamón.
Ah, ¿nada?
No, palito de queso. Te puedo ofrecer, pero palito de queso.
Ok.
Solamente
una,
queso.
Una, por favor. ¿Cuánto es?
1,500.
Gracias.
Gracias.
They don't have empanadas for me.
Only with meat?
We have this palito de queso.
Mi amor, que te vaya super bien.
Muchas gracias.
Ciao.
Right. They're super friendly, but they only had empanadas with meat, so I have the palito de queso. I don't know what it is, it's something with cheese. Let's try it. Yeah, just this dough with cheese inside. Colombians love cheese. They love like bread with cheese. Not the healthiest, but super cheap. 1,500.
Let's see what they have on the other side here. Arepa de chocolo. One of my favorites. I'm not gonna have it now because I already have this with cheese. But really good. Put some butter on there. Hola. And with the cheese. Okay.
I was trying to eat less fried food, but here I am eating buñuelos and the palito de queso. All fried, guys. We're on the hunt for some juice, coffee or juice, I'm not sure yet. Let's have a look what we can find here.
We're back stuck with all the clothes here. What do they have here? It's food. Maybe here. Oh, what's this? Pizza? That's the empanadas. What do we have here? Arepas.
Let's cross the street here and try to find some juice.
right, successfully crossed. It looks like a juice place. Let's see.
Buenas.
Buenas. Hola.
Hola.
¿Qué jugos tienes?
Jugo de naranja y preparadito con proteínas y vitaminas.
¿Solo es eso?
Jugo de naranja.
Ok.
Con proteínas y vitaminas.
¿Pues normal?
Normal.
Sí. ¿Qué es el precio?
5,000.
5,000. Gracias. Gracias.
Gracias.
Muy rico. Sí. Salud.
All right. Let's try juice here.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Punto de la naranja. Okay. That's why we have a naranja juice.
Orange juice.
I don't know why it's only naranja. They have all these other fruits. ¿Y todas las frutas? ¿Es decoración?
Sí, decoración.
Es solo decoración. Okay. Muchas gracias por tu trabajo. Muchas gracias.
Wow. We have to be really grateful for the people cleaning up the place here.
Oh, they have more here. Maybe I should have come here.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. People love the camera here. Then they get shy.
Alright guys, we're gonna take the metro back. So here in San Antonio, you have both lines A and B. And it's the end of the B line, that's the one we're going to take to San Javier. Which is on the highest level.
So line B goes from San Antonio to San Javier. Then to go to Laureles, we're gonna get off at Estadio.
If you take the metro here in Colombia, you have to do a lot of stairs always, because the metro is up in the air. It's not underground here, it's built up. So here we're at the first level, and our train is actually up there. We're going that direction to San Javier. This is where we enter.
Let me just look for my Civica car.
Oh, that's a Civica car.
So if you want to take any public transport that's within the metro system, that could be
the metro, like the one here, but this is not the line we need.
Or it could be metro buses and the cable cars. Then you need the Civica car
to enter the system and use the system.
Oh, and there's a tram as well going from San Antonio here.
All right. We have many people here.
One ride costs about 3,000, which is like 70 euro cents.
That's a lot of people. Let's go to the end, because most people are here in the front. As you can see, they put these platforms on the tracks. There are two tracks here. But because the train comes like this, it just leaves again like that.
I guess that's why they changed the system.
So we're not on this one, we'll take the next one. But you can see here everyone's on their phone, so once you're on the metro,
it's pretty fine to use your phone, just be careful for a pickpocket.
Yeah. Alright guys, we're at Estadio. I'm gonna go down here. I'm gonna go out here. You don't
need the Civica car to exit. You can just exit.
And now we are straight on La 70. Thank you for traveling with us.
Thank you guys for watching the video. I hope it was interesting. It was a bit more difficult to film because I was on a tour. But I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, share, subscribe. If you want to support me, you can join my Patreon. The link is in the description of this video.
and I'm gonna go here home on La 70.
See you guys for the next one. Ciao.